Hello, welcome to video number 2 in the Graphs and Networks course. So in this video, we'll be going over three topics. Namely, the first topic would be degree of a graph. Then I'll be going through one theorem. And lastly, we'll be looking at regular graphs. Alright, so starting with the degree. So the number of edges incident on a vertex U in G, G is a graph, is called the degree or valence of the vertex U in graph G, and it is denoted by degree of U. So let's illustrate what degree exactly is with these three examples. So in your first example, you see that there is a graph. You have five vertices, u1, u2, u3, u4, u5. They're connected by the edges marked in red. So by the definition of a degree, let's write the degree for u1. So the definition says that the number of edges incident on a vertex is its degree. So for u1, you can see that there are three vertices, three edges, u1, u5, u1, u4, and u1, u2. So its degree is 3. Similarly for u2, there are 3 edges incoming to it, so its degree is 3. For u3, its degree is 2. For u4, its degree is 3. And u5, its degree is 3. So that's all the degrees for all the vertices. Similarly for this example, in this graph you see that there are four vertices, u1, u2, u3, u4, and all the edges are marked in red connecting these vertices. So for u1, you see that there are 2 edges incident on it, so its degree is 2. For u2, there are 3 edges. For u3, there are 3 edges, and for u4, there are 2 edges, so its degree is 2. Similarly, in this example, let's first list down all the vertices and its corresponding degrees. This is known as a complete bipartite graph. It's got a special name. There will be a separate video on this, so don't really worry about this now. Alright, so let's list down the degrees. So for u1, you see that there are 3 edges incident on it, so its degree is 3. Similarly for u2, u3, u4, u5 and u6. So in this case, the degree of every vertex is same. Alright, so I hope this makes sense. Alright. Alright. Okay, so next we'll be going over a theorem. This is really fundamental theorem in graph theory, and it is really a stepping stone for solving all the questions that you might encounter. So let's proceed. So this theorem states that if G is a PQ graph where P is a number of vertices and Q is a number of edges, then summation degree of V for all V is equal to 2Q. So in simpler terms, this essentially says that if you sum the degree of each vertex for all the vertices, you result in twice the number of edges. Alright, so let's try to prove this. So I'll be proving this with induction, so proof by induction. There are multiple ways in which you can prove this, but I generally prefer the induction method. So let's first start with the base case. I'll be using the edges for proving. So base case, let Q equal to 0. So essentially, this means that you have a graph G. It's an arbitrary graph with P vertices and 0 edges. Now, by definition, if there are 0 edges, that means that for any vertex, there is no edge incident on it. So that means that degree of v for all v belonging to your vertex set is 0. That means that when you sum all your degrees for all v, you result in 0, which is equal to 2q, because q is 0. Alright, so that means that you've proved your base case. Now let's go over the induction hypothesis step. Alright, so assume that for some k belongs to your natural numbers. So for some k belonging to the natural numbers, there exists an arbitrary graph. There exists an arbitrary graph with p vertices and k edges. Alright. So, and we assume that the statement that we have to prove is true. So that means that summation of degree of all v, degree of a vertex, and summing over all the vertices is equal to 2k, because we have k edges. Right? It was 2q in the statement, but since we have k equals q for this case, it is equal to 2k. All right. Now we'll do the induction step. All right. Let G of vertex set V and its set E, this is an arbitrary graph with P vertices and K plus 1 edges. All right. This is like, this is a template for induction proofs. For the hypothesis, you work with k, and for the induction step, you work with k plus 1. Alright, now you consider a new graph g prime of v prime and e prime that is constructed by this graph is constructed by removing an edge. From G. Alright. So this can be an arbitrary edge. I'm just going to name the edge as E as U comma V. So the edge connecting U, vertex named U and vertex named V, I'm going to remove that. Now, so if you see carefully, your G prime is a graph with P vertices and K edges. Right? Since you removed one edge from K plus 1, you're left with K. Now, this graph G prime is similar to the graph that we had mentioned in the induction hypothesis, all right? This step. So that means that it is a similar graph, so it follows the same result. So that would mean, so summation of degree of v for all vertices v is equal to 2 times k. All right, since it follows a similar type of graph. Now what if we add that edge E that we removed back into the graph? So we'll now going to add that edge E equal to U comma V back into the graph. Now it's obvious that when you add an edge E, that the edge that you removed, you're adding it back. So it increases the degree of u by 1 and the degree of v by 1. So when you add it, your degree of u increases by 1 and your degree of v also increases by 1. And it does not affect the degree of any other vertex. So that from this step, we know that the sum of degrees increases by 2, one from here and one from here. Therefore we have that summation of degree of v for all v belonging to your capital V is equal to summation of all v belonging to v prime degree of each vertex plus 2. From this step, we know that degree of all v in for all the vertices of v prime, that is equal to 2k. So we get this is equal to 2 times k plus 1. And if you look carefully, k plus 1 is your number of edges. So that is equal to 2 times number of edges. So you have proved this theorem with the help of induction. Alright, let's move on to the final topic for this video, regular graphs. So a graph G, V, IE is known as a regular graph if delta G is equal to capital delta G. So this delta G is known as the minimum degree and this is known as your maximum degree. It's just a notation, not that significant as of now. Alright, so this is small delta and this is capital delta. So any graph in which your minimum degree is equal to your maximum degree, it's known as a regular graph. So a R regular graph is a graph in which degree of each vertex is R greater than or equal to 0. So let's take this example first. You have 4 vertices, u1, u2, u3, u4. For each vertex, you see that the degree for each vertex is 3, right? And that is equal to your maximum degree and your minimum degree. So this means that this is known as a 3 regular graph. Take this example. Let's take another example. So in this graph you have 5 vertices, u1, u2, u3, u4 and u5. And for each vertex, you see that its degree is 4. So that means that this is a 4 regular graph. Alright. So there can be many R regular graphs for a fixed number of vertices, but your regular graphs cannot be equal to your number of vertices because your R regular of R is always less than or equal to your n. It's always less than n. You can't have a 5 regular graph for 5 vertices, okay? It's always less than n. This is an important result that will be useful later on. So to summarize our video or lecture, we first learnt about a degree of a graph. Then we proved an important theorem, a fundamental theorem though. Then in conclusion, we looked at regular graphs. So that's it for this video. In the next video, I'll be dwelling into the subject slightly more. So hope you like this video. Please like, share and subscribe if you found it helpful. and share it with your friends who are in college. It might make their day and might be pretty helpful. All right, signing off. Bye-bye.